let's have a clear division between the sin-free and the God-free, shall we, please? I'm appealing for division, which is the direct opposite of Satan's way of appealing for unity of all things. Let's not have inclusion. Let's do God's ordinance. Division is our God's way. There's division now between the wheat and the tares on the earth. There's division when the Lord God calls us out, his people, from the world. There's division when the division, the split takes place between the narrow wayers and broad roaders. There is division when we come to judgment day, when the Lord God divides those whose names are in the book of life from those whose names are not. And those whose names do not appear in the book of life are thrown into the lake of fire, forever divided from those who live with him as children of God forever. Our God is about perfecting children for himself. To us who received him, he gave us the right to become the children of God. He seeds a single right to you and to me, one. He doesn't seed any other rights to anybody else. The people of the world, he doesn't give them any rights at all. Rights, one right for you and for me. We've got one. We're only wretched, stinking human beings. And thank God he bothered to give us a right. We'd be like the people of the world who think they're full of rights. If we hadn't been saved from sin to our Lord, right? However, this is an appeal, there should be proper division now. We have tried so hard to try and get people who are godless heathens to stop and repent, stop playing church, stop spitting on Jesus on this issue and that issues, like bitchcraft, like sodomites, like, you know, I know, interfaith and all kinds of stuff, but they won't. The church people are now totally determined on their own way. As the scripture says, the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but heap unto themselves teachers having itching ears, be turned from the truth and turned unto the fables. And if that hasn't happened in recent years, I don't know what has happened. Right? How sad. But can we, the ones and twos that are left, that are dotted around, the few disciples there are, we better cling together and A, to encourage each other for fellowship, because we can't fellowship with the God-frees, we're the sin-frees. We live in purity and holiness, which we can be, and we perfect holiness in the fear of the Lord, as the Lord God quite clearly says. Holiness, innocence, and purity. Okay. Can I suggest we all stop trying to correct the God-frees, the church people, and we leave them to their own way? Now, they're free to be as wicked as they like. That's their call, please. We don't try and make church people behave like disciples. They don't want to know. We don't talk to them about anything but normal social interaction or chit-chat, you know, one way or another. We don't do it. There's no point. What's the point? Piggy slapping and pork wrestling. It doesn't work. And you're looking at a black belt piggy slapper. You know, I've tried so hard, but actually all it does is upset them. And of course, when you point out and they've shown to be absolutely wrong and you are conclusively right by God, then they'll start going into politics about how God's order has been thrown away and the Lord God doesn't care today what we do, despite the fact that Jesus said clearly in Matthew 5, the law of God still stands. Because come judgment day, when you and I as disciples are stood there, guess which standard it is that's used to assess what we've done? The law of God shows the standard. The law of God still stands, only its application has radically changed. So can I appeal for proper division now? And let's make sure that we ply the 1 John 4 test. If somebody doesn't pass that test, whether they are secular, that they're not pretending to be one of God's people, they're just secular folks, well, we wouldn't talk to them about the holy things of God anyway. But the church people, you know, Satan's Christians, the Godfreys, we'll leave the Godfreys to their path. That's what they've chosen. Please, we don't try and force people to do things. We're not like a bunch of Catholics. We don't go around murdering people to enforce the authority of the satanic filth of Catholicism on people. We don't do that. Judge not that you be not judged. That's exactly what Jesus meant by that. We lead them to their way, to the church people who are constantly bringing in the poo into the fellowship, trying to paint the feces to make them acceptable to God. Give them a lick of camouflage paint and then perhaps the Lord won't burn them. Well, I'm terribly sorry. God is looking at the heart. He knows who's his and who is not. And if you think Christianizing people is going to preserve their sinful backside, including your own children, you're off your head. However, this is deadly serious stuff, and let's take a real good think about this. All of us have a good think about this, because what does this actually mean? It means there's very, very few of us. Very few. And perhaps we all look for comfort. We all want there to be a nice, big, local fellowship full of godly and holy people. Doesn't that... Sorry. And you must be very, very careful who you open up to. Very careful. They don't pass the 1 John 4 test, then I'm afraid they're antichrists if they're claiming to be Christians. They're not disciples at all. There's got to be proper division here, a clean line of demarcation. But when you think about it, that what the Lord is after is sons, children of God. Children of God. We aren't going to be children of God if we are filling our hearts and lives with the cares of the world, what the Godfreys are doing here, and the fact that the Godfreys are spitting on God and his ordinance here and spitting on it there because they're a share of popes and believe they have authority to vary and overthrow God and his ordinance. They're not with God. They don't care what God says, thinks, or wants. And they think anybody who does to be a complete fundamentalist raving nutter. But we walk with him, don't we? Godfreys get burnt. The vast bulk of church people will be going to the lake of fire. Still trying to overthrow God's way and shouting and railing at God because they did Christianity and surely they should be accepted. But I think we need to really have a good think about this. If you and I are going to become fully in the likeness of Jesus Christ, then I'm afraid we are going to be in tears at the state of the Godfreys, like Paul was, weeping over those who are walkers, the enemies of the cross. But we have a tremendous reward ahead of us. Family of God. Family. Family of God. Did you hear that? If you've been initially saved, you have the right to become a child of God, a son, daughter, with the Son, number one Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And ultimately, his family is all that's on the earth, post-judgment day. Everybody else is in the lake of fire. Why are we taking any notice at all of what the Godfreys, both secular and religious, think about anything? Or what they're up to? Let's leave them on their way. We tried very, very hard. They are dead set now on their way, and I believe the Lord God has given them over. You know that Romans 1, I think it is, chapter about, because they did not like to retain the knowledge of God, a consciousness and awareness of God. God gave them over to dishonor their bodies, etc., etc. And you know that in the tail end of the Old Covenant, the Lord God disinherited his entire Old Covenant people, lock, stock and barrel. One or two people qualified, and here we are in the New Testament era, and I believe he's disinherited his entire body of New Covenant people. He's cut them off. And the churches are doing and saying bizarre stuff, absolutely bizarre. And I hope sincerely all of you are not actually taking any notice of that. Just because they use his name doesn't mean they're one of his people, does it? Let's ignore them. Let's concentrate on our family, the family of God. We forget all about the Godfreys and all their horrors and horrible things they're up to. And let's press on in there.